Dr. Deshano Palami, School President, Dr. Sonia Palami, School Director, distinguished guests, members of the Board of Trustees, parents, graduates, a pleasant afternoon. See, I've just finished college, so I'm fresh from everything with school, and I've been ruminating long and hard, trying to determine what exactly this arduous academic journey has amounted to. I have spent 16 long years, a whopping 80% of my life, in the comfort of school. But now that everything has finally ended, where do I go? In a greater sense, what does everything mean at the end of the day? What are medals and academic accolades? What are diplomas but mere pieces of paper? The congratulations that you will hear are but simple words. They resonate and they disappear. In one of my conversations with a professor in college, he asked me, "Ano ngayon kung atinista ka?" The question I extend. "Ano ngayon kung graduate ka na? Gutom pa rin ang bata sa lansangan? Inanakawan pa rin tayo ng mga trapo? Uhaw pa rin sa ustisya ang mga pamilya at ng mga biktima na pamas lang ng mga ambatuan?" Basically, so what? Dearest graduates, tonight I offer you not advice or a tribute, but instead a simple request. As you venture into college, you will find answers to your deepest personal inquiries. To the existential, who am I? On to the more pragmatic, what is it that I'm meant to do? Amidst all these, however, I implore you never to get lost in the maze of the personal and realize constantly that inasmuch as we are individuals, the meaning of our being lies in the interpersonal, sa pakikipagkapwa. Pilipino tayo dahil sa kapwa Pilipino. Nagtapos tayo dahil at para sa ating mga magulang. Masaya tayo ngayon, bagamat may halong konting lungkot dahil sa ating mga kaibigan. It is the other, those other than ourselves, that give meaning to our existence. You see, to know the other in your life is not merely the end-all and the be-all. There are others not in our immediacy that need our attention. I have sat beside the workers of tahanan na walang hagdanan, reminiscing with them the days when they had been, before they had been held captive by their wheelchairs, relishing the simple dignity of going to the comfort room without the aid of other people. I spent the weekend with the families from those in New Bilibid prison, lamenting with them about the slow cadence of our justice system. I tutored children from the slums of the Metropolitan, dreaming with them about big houses and fancy cars. If you are with those other than yourselves, especially those who are rarely heard and noticed, you will find that amidst everything you have learned and achieved, hindi ka pa rin sapat. I found myself lacking and insufficient, pushed to the brink of tears by my own incapacity. After everything that I have learned in school, I found myself in pieces. Binasag ako ng karanasan ng pagiging kulang. You have finished an amazing chapter in your life. Whenever I look back to high school, I often smile and laugh at all the memories and I have people whom I share lasting friendships with. I congratulate you for having survived the papers, the graded recitations, the exams in math and science, whatever subject, everything that your teachers have thrown in your way. Yet the journey is not yet complete and the future beckons. Let this be a journey not only for yourself, but also for those who love and hope in you, for those who love and hope with you. Offer this journey too for those who have been forced to abandon theirs so that they can work for their family. I tell you that within each of you is the immense potential to change the world. This is not merely a cliche to make you feel better about yourselves, but a challenge and a hope. Wika nga, lahat tayo parang posporo. May tagline na kakaibang liwanag para sa sarili, para sa iba, para sa lahat. Kailangan lang ng pagkukuskos. Although I found myself in pieces, I also found within me a deeper desire to serve. To not only work for a living, but to work for something life-giving. I hope the same for you. One alumna of this school that I greatly look up to has done her share. A part of the pioneer batch of Stephanie graduates, Jemima Soledad, works with agrarian reform beneficiaries in Mindanao when she could have had a posh corporate job in Manila. She says about her decision to join the Jesuits volunteer program, "Leaving has its purposes, and I have a purpose to animate. I left, yes, but I left to live for something greater than myself, and to be life-giving to others as well." You see, to live for something greater than yourself. If you aspire for that, then the possibilities. If you aspire for that, then the possibilities are endless and infinite. With that, again, a pleasant afternoon.